Sleeping in My Car, a song written in anger, fury and rage. Disappointment. In 1993. Why?
Well, we had a listening session for our record label in Stockholm with the whole Crash Boom Bang album. And they liked the album. We were really proud of the album. They liked it a lot. But as many record companies say, we can't hear the first single. And I thought I thought the album was packed with singles, you know, Run to You, Fireworks, all those songs. But anyway, I went home and I wrote an up-tempo track, which turned out to be Sleeping in My Car. And so the next day, we hit the studio while we were working on the second floor, Studio One at EMI in Stockholm, recording. Me and Anders, our bass player, went into Studio Two to start working on a new song, which was Sleeping in My Car. So this is just a demo. There were no real musicians around, so maybe I'm playing the drums here, or maybe Anders is playing the drums. And Marie came by and she started singing. It was the wrong key for her, so it sounds really terrible, but this is how it happened. So we used it as a B-side for the Sleeping in My Car single way back. But I think it's funny to hear, because this is how it was created.
Who's playing the guitar? You remember that? Is that you?
Probably me, yeah.
Yeah. Is that a 12-string guitar? Sounds like a 12-string.
I don't know.
No?
I don't know if it's a guitar even. I can't remember. I just know that we did it really quick. This took like 2 hours or so.
And then you went up and presented it for the record company, for EMI.
No, Marie loved it. And so she said, we have to record it in a proper key so I can sing it the way I wanted to sing it. And I played it for our producer, Clarence Overman. He didn't like it at all. So basically what I did that we Clarence, you should produce it, but we're going to use different players. We used different players on the song. We had another drummer. And we had another lead guitar player and another bass player. So we just had a brand new band that didn't sound like anything else on that album. But to me, it was just a bona fide power pop song.